With the introduction of exotic seeds, the presence of indigenous seeds has slowly depleted with time. However, the result to this effect speaks louder now than ever as legislators weigh in on the same matter.
Development, we shouldn't leave our tradition. Our tradition is our heritage, our tradition is our wealth, and our tradition shouldn't be in statements. It should be felt like the way we are seeing it here today.
The seeds we have right now, when we give them to our farmers, they can't be replanted. Yet if these indigenous seeds can be kept for seasons, our people in the villages, also the farmers, are very poor. They can't support, they can't afford buying seeds every season. So if we put in more effort to support Peram to promote our indigenous groups, we are supporting seeds, we are supporting our farmers so that they can be keeping seeds to replant each season so that they can be able to have enough food in their homes.
Unlike exotic seeds, legislators say that indigenous seeds are renowned for their advantages reflecting on past experiences. These say that introduction of exotic seeds partly explains weak immune systems amongst the people.
Our main purpose and inquisitiveness to attend this function today is to bring our solidarity and total commitment as Parliament of Uganda that we are fully behind you in supporting and promoting, advocating for our indigenous seed and crops.
We need to encourage the indigenous crops, which are free from process of malfunctioning our bodies. Now, they have disappeared simply because they introduced exotic type, which in one way tends to kill the glorification of the indigenous crops.
Members of Parliament have also grounded the upsurge of aflatoxins on drifting away from indigenous farming practices. Aflatoxins are fungotoxins that contaminate particular agriculture foods, especially in storage facilities where agriculture produce is often kept.
Put interest in storage, post-harvest handling. You're hearing about aflatoxins. There's a lot of mycotoxins in our food stuff. Yet Uganda is only having 17.1% chemical in their food, the best in Africa. So we have this liberty. We have this open check. It's just a matter of putting policies that can regulate our food production.
The Participatory Ecological Land Use Management, Pelham, Uganda, has against this background asked the government to offer more support to women who have proven to be custodians of indigenous seeds and other plant genetic materials.
The seed fairs, we have seen women, more women, even when you go here, you will see most of the exhibitors are women. And that has reaffirmed to us that in Africa, women are the custodians of seed. All the custodians of plant genetic materials, and therefore they need the support that is required. If we are designing programs, even in agriculture, we must have specific programs that are going to target these women because they have played a very big role. Apart from also playing a big role in agricultural production, but they are keeping our plant genetic materials.
This was during the 13th Annual Indigenous and Traditional Food and Seed Fair, themed on nurturing health, nutritious and resilient food systems for all, organized by Pelham Uganda in collaboration with the Government of Uganda.
To request
Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.